بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. This is Ibraheem Menk recording for the Daily Reminder Network. عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال إن لله 99 اسما 100 إلا واحدة من أحصاها دخل الجنة رواه البخاري ومسلم. أبو هريرة رضي الله عنه narrates that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم has said, Verily Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has 99 names, 100 except one. The one who has memorized, understood, implemented in his life these qualities has entered Jannah. This hadith is recorded by Bukhari and Muslim. In this beautiful hadith, the Prophet ﷺ is explaining to us that the one who has memorized, understood and implemented these qualities in his life has entered Jannah. This is so because the one who has recognized Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this way realizes that the obligations that are placed upon him were placed by a very great being. So this being is truly worthy of worship and thereby worships Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the way that he is supposed to do so. We implement the qualities of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in our lives. How do we do this? One may wonder that this is strange to a certain extent. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is jameel, yuhibbul jamal. He is beautiful and he loves beauty. So we are beautiful in everything that we do. In the way we walk, in the way we talk, in what we eat, in everything that we do, we are beautiful. And thereby we are actually implementing a quality of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in our lives in a very humanly way. Obviously, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not similar to anything. The ayah actually says,
لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِهِ شَيْءٌ وَهُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْبَصِيرُ.
There is nothing that is similar to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and He is all hearing and all seeing. Finally, we understand that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has asked of us to call out to Him using His names. He says,
وَلِلَّهِ الْأَسْمَاءُ الْحُسْنَى فَادْعُوهُ بِهَا وَذَرُوا الَّذِينَ يُلْحِدُونَ فِي أَسْمَائِهِ سَيُجْزَوْنَ مَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ.
That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has the glorious names, so call out to Him using these names. Imagine asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Tawwab, tub alayya, Ya Ghafoor, ighfir li, Ya Rahim, irhamni. It is definitely more eloquent than just saying, Give me, or something of that nature. Finally, we understand that these names, the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, are not only 99. But the one who has memorized, understood and implemented, called out to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala using these names has entered Jannah. This is what is meant by the hadith. Like one who says, I have $1,000 that I have kept for sadaqah. It does not mean that this man has only $1,000, but what it means that he has kept these 1,000 for sadaqah. With that we say, wa sallallahu wa sallama wa baraka ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in.